As a first step, we will define the structural grid for the building. Let's select Design, Grid System from the menu. The ARCHICAD grid system makes it really easy to define complex column beam grids for your design. The grid includes not only just the 3D model elements, but also the grid lines, numberings, and other annotation elements needed in the floor plan, section, and 3D views. A dialog box comes up where we can determine what the grid should look like. Display the Grid Positions panel of the Grid System Settings dialog. The Grid Positions panel deals with the basic geometry of the grid. Here we can add and remove horizontal and vertical grid lines, specifying the distance between them. Certainly, the distances don't have to be uniform between the grid lines. Click once to select the first horizontal grid line in the list on the left. Click the minus sign to delete all additional grid lines. Now click the plus sign once to add a new horizontal grid line, and enter 6,000 for distance. Now click the plus sign 5 more times to create additional grid lines. We need 7 horizontal grid lines altogether. Now select the first vertical grid line and delete all the other entries. Add a new grid line and enter 6,000 for the distance. Finally, add new vertical grid lines. We need 12 vertical grid lines altogether. The distance between the grid line axes is 6,000 millimeters. Open the General Settings panel. This determines how the grid will be displayed on the floor plan and in sections. Here you can also define which other elements should be placed together with the grid. Here, we opt to place a column at each grid intersection. Checkmark the Elements at Grid Line Intersection option. Make sure that Column is selected. And finally, click Settings to open the Column Default Settings dialog to modify the properties of the columns to be placed. Display the Geometry and Positioning panel. Set the column top to First Story, Home plus 1. Enter minus 200 millimeters for the top offset to top linked story value. Enter 300 millimeters for the core dimensions of the column. Make sure that reinforced concrete structural is set for material. Display the floor plan and section panel, and make sure that the floor plan display show on stories option is set to all relevant stories. Finally, click OK to close this dialog. Also, it's nice to have the grid line dimensions placed automatically so that we don't have to deal with them later. To place the dimension lines automatically, check the Dimension Lines checkbox in the Grid System Settings dialog. Display the Grid Elements panel. Here we can set the line type of the grid on floor plan, section, and elevation as well as in 3D views. Click Grid Element Settings to display the corresponding dialog. Select the dot and dashed line type on the floor plan panel. Display the section and elevation panel and select the dot and dashed line type there too. Click OK to close this dialog. Click OK once more to close the Grid System Settings dialog as well. ARCHICAD will prompt that the layer we are about to use is locked, so click Unlock Layer to unlock it. As you move the cursor around, a preview of the grid system follows it. Let's click twice on the project origin to place the grid. The grid system is placed instantly. Zoom out if necessary. Select any of the grid elements and note the entire grid system will be selected. Open the Grid Element Settings dialog box. Set the Show on Story to All Stories in order to show the grid on all the stories. Click OK. Let's view the grid system in 3D. Click on the View, Editing Plane Display menu item, in order to see the editing plane in the 3D window in case it's not yet visible. Now we will remove the unnecessary columns from the grid. Return to the floor plan view. Select the Marquee tool in the toolbox. Define an area around the left 6 columns of the top row. Activate the Column tool in the toolbox. Select all columns within the marquee by activating the Edit, Select All Columns, or use the equivalent keyboard shortcut. Delete the selected elements with the Backspace key. Please note that you can lock grid and dimension layers. Select the grid element, and then activate the Layers, Lock Layer option from the context menu. This way, you can select columns using the normal selection method and delete them. Select the Marquee tool again, and define a new area around the right 6 columns of the bottom row. Select all the columns in the marquee and delete them as described above. Press Escape once to remove the marquee area. If you locked the grid and dimensions layer earlier, please do not forget to unlock these after deleting the columns. We have to resize the inner columns to 500 by 500 millimeters. To select these columns quickly, use the Marquee tool again, and set the geometry method to polygonal in the info box. Draw a marquee area as presented on the screen. Select all columns in the marquee by activating the Column tool, and then the Edit Select All Columns option. Open the Column Selection Settings dialog, and open the Geometry and Positioning page. Modify the size of the column from 300 mm to 500 mm. Change the heights of the columns to be linked to the 21st story. Make sure that the top offset value is set to minus 200. Click OK to close this dialog. These columns will be seen on all relevant stories automatically.